मॉर्निंग मैम।
मॉर्निंग बेटा। करें स्टार्ट फिर। वी वर वी नो के देयर आर टू ओके वी वर डूइंग देयर आर टू थ्योरीज ऑफ इंटेलिजेंस ऑल ऑफ यू नो वन इज योर फैक्टर थ्योरीज एंड द अदर वन इज योर इंटेलिजेंस थ्योरी सॉरी प्रोसेस थ्योरीज नाउ वन थ्योरी गिव्स इंपॉर्टेंस टू द different different factors which are important for the intelligence and then others they give importance to the process of which are important for intellectual kind of functioning from which you include whether the person is intelligent ya nahi and under that we have now first theory which we factor theories we will cover is our okay Spearman's two factor theory okay and in this see as you see in this our slide G is in the center of your abilities now if your G is high okay then probably you perform well in almost majority of the fields okay at least if you're not good but when you're taught something you at least grasp much faster than the person who's poor on G factor okay and then we have all other specific abilities that may be 1, 2, 3 many kinds of them one may be what आगे जो भी हम पढ़ेंगे बिने सॉरी स्पीयरमैन नेवर मेंशन्ड व्हाट आर दी स्पेसिफिक एबिलिटीज ओके ही ओनली सेड कि देर आर टू फैक्टर्स वन इज द जनरल फैक्टर एंड अदर इज द स्पेसिफिक फैक्टर बट व्हेन अदर्स स्टार्टेड एनालाइजिंग देन दे केम टू यू नो और से और एक्सप्लेन अबाउट स्पीयरमैन कि दी स्पेसिफिक एबिलिटीज आर मच मोर क्लोजर टू द एप्टीट्यूड्स ओके एंड देन मे बी कि वन इज गुड एट म्यूजिक वन मे बी गुड एट कारपेंट्री वन मे बी गुड एट पेंटिंग वन मे बी गुड एट सो दैट इज हिज स्पेसिफिक एरिया वेयर दैट पर्सन इज कुड परफॉर्म बेटर These were the two, and most of our tests, which were in the beginning, which were developed, they were based mostly to measure the general intelligence of the person, and these specific abilities were measured by the aptitude test. Then after that, but Spearman's in the beginning when it came, it was recognized quite a bit, and it did. Create a commotion in the intelligence testing but later when the people came they started criticizing Spearman's concept and it they started saying ki like when the factors came into when Binay Kamath was there Binay was only insisting on one factor and if you go through his test paper you will find कि मोस्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस वर मैचिंग
एक्सक्यूज मैम
यस
यस मैम सौम्या इज इन द वेटिंग रूम कैन यू प्लीज लेट हर इन शी इज बीन वेटिंग फॉर अ व्हाइल
हाँ सही
ओके थैंक
ओके Vinayat Bhatt was the one who was, who just said there's only one factor, and that is the intelligence. Then Spearman came and said, no, there are two factors. But when this factor concept emerged, then there was a criticism for Spearman, where the people came to say, there are not two factors. If you question, then there are multiple factors. Under multiple factors came the theory of Thurston. Thurston said there are not two factors, but there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 factors, and he called it as a primary mental abilities. Each factor measuring one factor and the other measuring the other factor. Okay, now what were these 7 factors about primary factors of mental abilities? One was verbal, the ability to understand the meaning of words, like how good you are on the language part. Okay, then second was the comprehension. Vocabulary tests represent this factor, and first is verbal comprehension itself. Sorry, it's not a thing. Verbal comprehension, where it tells you the ability of the person to understand language. Okay, when you give the instructions, that person comprehends. ठीक है, या आफ्टर रीडिंग जस्ट ए मिनट विट इज सम बिट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम. Okay, then comes word fluency. Second factor is word fluency, the ability to think of words rapidly, as in solving anagrams or thinking of words that rhyme. Okay, if you just ask a person, okay, I give you word rain, now give me what are the other words which are similar in that tone, like rain, crane, that kind of things. So the majority of the words the person gives, that means the one who gives more words, that means he is much more fluent with the words. Okay, then comes the numbers, dealing with the number, the ability to work with numbers and perform computations, like mathematical ability. Then comes space, the ability to visualize space from relationships, as in recognize the same figure presented in different orientations. We have nowadays in intelligence test those questions where you give a person and then you rotate it at 90%, yeah, 80%, yeah, you invert the figure. Okay, so those kind of things, as you have it in Raven's progressive matrix, that is also your space only. Okay, so these are the special ability. Who's good at special ability, girls or boys?
I'm females.
No, the boys are good at special ability. Okay, then comes our memory, the ability to recall verbal stimuli such as the word pairs or sentences. We used to have, I don't know, you even might have done also, there was practical on paired test and unpaired test to measure the memory. Certain words are given which are paired words, like chair and table. Then after you have read that word, okay, then there may be another word, chair and thread. Chair and table is a paired word. Chair and thread is not a paired word. They are distant words. Okay. Then after you have remembered, like after you have learned these two lists, then the one word will be given to you. And then you have to recall the other pair of that word. And it was found where the words are paired words, they are recalled much better than the unpaired words. See, I just tell you this test because you should know all these tests and it will be helpful for you. Okay. Then comes our perceptual speed. Perceptual speed is, it tests your observation also. And how quickly you, you know, discriminate two words, whether they are similar or unsimilar. And this perceptual speed tests were usually used to select the people for clerical kind of jobs. ठीक है ना? These were called clerical jobs. Like these tests were used for clerical jobs. There used to be 100 words. ठीक है? And then one by one, they try to find out ki which are similar, like picking up the mistakes or something like that. Then comes reasoning. Reasoning ability is the ability to find a general rule on the basis of presented instance, as in determining how a numbers of series, like at the reasoning test, so we, there are different tests which measure your reasoning ability. Like if I give you series of the words, 2, 4, 6, 8, which we discussed the other day also. These are the tests. So now to compromise again, to summarize this, under primary mental abilities, we have verbal comprehension, where you, your ability to handle language part is done. Then is word fluency. Then is number, space, memory, perceptual speed, and reasoning. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 7 primary mental abilities. Okay, so it, Spearman's concept was criticized of having two factors. Now, now emerge the 7 factors. After that, Guilford, I think I should go to another definition by Gardner. Then Harvard Gardner, he gave 9 factors. Okay, and he called this as a multiple intelligence. Gardner said there are multiple intelligence, and first intelligence for him is, he has just elaborated bit of Thurston's primary factors itself. One is linguistic intelligence, ability to communicate through language. Then comes logical mathematical intelligence, ability to analyze arguments and solving mathematical problems. Spatial intelligence, ability to perceive and arrange objects. Musical intelligence, ability to analyze, compose, or perform music. Then bodily kinesthetic intelligence, ability to move effectively. Interpersonal intelligence, ability to understand other people. Then intrapersonal intelligence, ability to understand self. Then naturalist, ability to understand the patterns found in the natural environment. And then comes the existential intelligence. It is a philosophical oriented ability which is used to find out answers to the questions about the meaning of one's existence, life and death. Now, based on these 9 factors of intelligence, he has described which kind of job they will be fitting into. Now, if you are good at linguistic intelligence, just a minute, some problem. Okay, now if you are good at linguistic problems, which kind of jobs you will be good at? Writing, journalist, poet, playwright, radio announcer, speech pathologist, typist, novelist, comedian, politician, orator, actor, curator. Because these are the people who need to handle the language part. Okay, then comes logical, mathematical intelligence. Here, careers like accountant, actuary, auditor, banker, bookkeepers, business persons, computer analysis, computer programmers, doctors, economists, legal assistant, mathematicians, purchasing agents, science research, science teachers, statisticians, technicians, and underwriters, they are all will be doing better if they have this logical, mathematical reasoning ability. Based on this concept itself is our, you know, trade allocation test. Like who has to be fitting into which kind of trade, they are used this. Then came bodily kinesthetic intelligence also. See, everybody can't dance, everybody can't be playing, everybody can't be good at sports. So he recognized the persons who are good at these abilities, they are also intelligent in that field, and in this he included jewelers, mechanics, then physical education teachers, physical therapists, recreationals, dancers, choreographer, carpenters, athletes, actors, and all, they were included into this category, or these are the people who will be high on their bodily kinesthetic intelligence, especially the dancers and the sports people. Then came musical intelligence, playing with the instruments, songwriters, performing musicians, piano turners, singers, advertising agents, conductor, composers, music teachers, okay? All those were falling into the category, like these are the kind of jobs which a person can do who is high on the musical intelligence. Then comes about interpersonal intelligence. This interpersonal intelligence is much more closer to your emotional intelligence, EQ. Okay, here it is something where you can understand the emotions of the others, especially in different situations, and then modify your own emotions to give the kind of reactions based on others' emotions. That's why here you are called emotionally intelligent person. That means you can understand the other's emotion, you can understand your situations, and then react according to the person's emotions. And here now, who are good administrators, anthropologists, arbitrators, counselors, PK nurses, and then even travel agents, teachers, therapists, sociologists, school principals, salesperson especially. Okay? These kind of professions are good professions for the person who is good at interpersonal relationships. Then there is another problem, which is called intrapersonal intelligence. Okay? Sometimes most of the problems do happen in our life where we do not have intrapersonal intelligence. You're not able to take decisions for yourself. Okay? You do a lot of work for others. Okay, be good. जिसने जो कह दिया वो कर दिया उसके लिए. Everything is fine. But when it comes to you, you're not able to take certain kind of actions. One thing, because see, other works we do because we are frightened of criticism from others. Okay, here when it comes to your interpersonal, you yourself will not criticize you. ठीक है, ओपनली. तो यहाँ हम लोग इसको लैग कर जाते हैं कई एक बार. ओके, सो फर्स्ट थिंग, इनफैक्ट फर्स्ट थिंग, इफ यू वांट टू कम अप इन लाइफ, यू हैव टू हैव इंट्रापर्सनल इंटेलिजेंस ऑफ योर्स. यू हैव टू हैव ए सेल्फ नॉलेज एंड एबिलिटी टू एक्ट अडाप्टिवली ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट नॉलेज. Having an accurate picture of oneself, one's strength and weaknesses, like you should know sometimes what happens, we have those kind of problems, जहाँ हमारे बहुत ज़्यादा हम high अपने goals बना लेते हैं. Okay, when you keep very high goals for yourself and you're not able to attain them, the problem starts from there. Now, why did that problem start? Because you did not know about your proper strengths and weaknesses. Okay, so when you do not know about your proper strength and weaknesses, then that means your intrapersonal intelligence is bit low. Okay, now another third factor is awareness of inner moods, intentions, motivations, temperaments, and desires. Then the capacity for self-discipline, self-understanding, and self-esteem. See, now just try to keep it in a try to join these all the concepts. First is you have to have a self-knowledge about self, yourself. And you should know what is your strengths and weaknesses. So based on that, you're trying to choose the goals of your life. Okay? Or you, this does not mean that you cannot aspire for high goals. You can aspire for high goals, but shorten them. Okay? Make them in a hierarchical fashion. Where first goal is easier to obtain, you reach that. It will give you a proper kind of, feedback. Your self-concept will be high. Then try to reach second, then try to reach third, and then try to reach fourth. And where you feel that you are not able to obtain later, then you have to accept that, look, my potentialities are only that much. Okay, now the other comes moods, your intentions, your motivations, your temperaments. Maybe there are certain situations in your daily life which disturbs your mood. Okay, yeah, it makes you get anger. Okay, so for time being, at least you can avoid those kind of situations. Yeah, have a conversation with you that you have to control your emotions when you go to that situation. For example, small example, okay, like you are in with your friends, when the another friend enters, probably you had some fight with that person, and your emotions get triggered. You may get angry over once that person comes. Though you're trying to control, you are not able to maintain that kind of interpersonal relationship. So now if you're aware, okay, when this friend comes, my temper goes up. At least you can move out of the group if you're not able to control yourself. Then you have to give kind of self-suggestions to you that you have to control your emotions. Okay, then comes, and now what kind of carriers are good? The person who has, more of self-awareness, they say it's a clergyman, psychology teacher, theologian, spiritual counselors, psychiatrists, philosophers, researchers, psychologists, they all are high on self-awareness. Then there's existential. Okay, it's not explained, but I'll talk about the existential. Existential intelligence. Where does this is important? When does existential crisis come? Jewel, you have joined today, let me know. Apurva, Jewel is there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Jewel. When do these existential problems come in individual's life?
Ma'am, your voice is, your audio level is low.
ओके वेन चलो वो तो कुछ नहीं कर सकती. एग्जिस्टेंशियल क्राइसिस कब आती है इंसान की जिंदगी में? व्हेन डू यू हैव एग्जिस्टेंशियल क्राइसिस? अपूर्वा जस्ट टेल यू.
अब ठीक है मैम, आवाज ठीक है
मैम. अराउंड मिडिल एज, इट्स आल्सो कॉल्ड मिडलाइफ क्राइसिस
मैम. आई थिंक सो एग्जिस्टेंशियल क्राइसिस ऑलमोस्ट स्ट्राइक्स अ पर्सन व्हेन ही इज kind of stuck in a plateau state where he is not able to move forward.
Yes,
that's exactly how a midlife also looks like, but it's not specific
it
to particular.
It can come at any stage. It yes. can come at any stage, but it is more with those people who have not, who is facing identity crisis.
Yes, ma'am.
ठीक है, यहाँ you are goalless.
Yes, ma'am.
ठीक है, and when you're low on the mood wise, like some people have depressive tendencies, not that depression as such, but you have depressive tendencies when you are more of negativistic kind of person, where there is you are low on hope. Okay, then comes our existential crisis. But if you are high on this existential intelligence, these problems will not lead you. Okay, even if you have nothing with you, because it's a more of a philosophical oriented approach, even if you have nothing in front of you and one belief that God has sent me on this earth with some kind of purpose, if you start searching a purpose in nothingness, that means you are high on existential intelligence. And once you are high on existential intelligence, you will not have identity crisis over there. You will find your identity with something or the other and move up in your life. It's just a simple example to make you understand about the existential crisis. Maybe there's little more in this. Okay, so it is it's a philosophically oriented ability which is used to find answers to the questions about the meaning of one's existence, okay, life and death. There is a say, na, one person says, somebody, life, what have you given me? Then the life asks that person, what have you given me? Okay, life we got. Now, for life, having got the life, we have to do certain things for the life. Okay, that is what is called existential intelligence. Okay, now after that came our cattle's. After explaining cattle, then I'll go to the Guilford's intelligence. Now, cattle said ki there are again two types. He mentioned about the two types of it. He did not say much about the factors, but he said there are two types of intelligence. One is your fluid intelligence and one is your crystallized intelligence. We have already discussed this the other day. Now, the fluid intelligence is capacity to deal with new problems that require such skills as perception, solving a picture puzzles. And on this fluid intelligence, at this age, all of you are good at this. Allows to acquire new knowledge and skills, presumed to be relatively independent of education and experience, usually useful particularly where flexible adaptation to novel situation is required. If you are put into a new situation, you can get adapted to that new situation much faster than the person who is low on the fluid intelligence. And then is crystallized intelligence, capacity to use an accumulated body of information to make judgments and solve problems, which you have learned through years, your own experiences, knowledge and skills that have been acquired and memorized, assumed to depend heavily on the culture and education. Higher you are educated, more experience you will get. You are in a rich culture, the more richly you will be having your crystallized intelligence. So it depends upon the past experiences. Now, when you look at the graph, how does the fluid and crystallized intelligence grow? Till about your early adulthood. For example, till about the age of 30, 35, 40 tak chale jao beshak. Theek hai? Ye fluid intelligence grows. At your prime age of yours, now you are at the maximum potentiality of your fluid intelligence. Okay, now after you cross this age, okay, maybe after around 35 and so, then your fluid intelligence starts dropping down. But the crystallized intelligence is low in the beginning, but it keeps on increasing and it goes till the end of your life. So crystallized intelligence keeps on growing, whereas fluid intelligence drops down. Okay, and this fluid and crystallized intelligence, there are certain abilities which keep on increasing with age. Okay, even if you take your primary mental abilities or you take multiple intelligence, there are certain abilities which keep on growing with the age. Yeah, they do not grow, but how much ever you have learned, they stay with you. And there are other abilities who starts falling down. Okay, and based on this only, there were certain tests which was developed and it was called DQ, hold versus don't hold abilities. Okay, when a test is given to you, if you are not able to get that much intelligence in your later ages, that was only you were failing on the don't hold test. Okay, so they used to do some mathematical calculations and then give some weightage to the people who were tested on those tests, if they were not getting that IQ, that may be due to the DQ. Don't hold test. Then comes the Guilford structure of intelligence. Binet gave one factor for intelligence. Spearman gave two factors. Then our Thurston gave seven factors, and Gardner gave nine factors. But when it came to Guilford, he started with 120 factors, moved to 150 factors, and finally came up to 180 factors. Somewhere, I don't know, I have read it, it was 240 factors also, but I'm not very sure. I tried to find out, but I could not get any proper reference on that. But I do remember somewhere ahead, some years back, I did read about 240 factors. Maybe he might have added some more factors into his factor list. Now, what is this? He has called it as a structure of intelligence. And this structure he compares with three factors of the cube. He compares it with the cube. Like when cube is kept in front of you, how many sides of the cube you are able to see? How many sides of the cube you see?
Three sides.
And here he has three factors, which are like he has divided three main factors, and under those three main factors there are other factors. Okay, now for the first factor he says is the content factor, then is operation, and then is the product. Okay, now to understand, before we understand, let's one small kind of example. Now, how do you say content? Content means from where you get the information. Okay, now if I say, I'm talking to you, and I say, okay, what is 2 plus 2? Okay, you have heard me. Okay, 2 plus 2, to now for giving me the answer, you have to do certain action, that is multiply. Content is you heard me saying, the stimuli is 2 into 2, you heard me saying, or you might have even seen it. Okay. The other question, example you can take, when you're sitting in the exam, you read a question. When you read a question, then you have to write about it. But before writing, you will try to recall it from your memory. Okay, what is the answer for that? Okay, that is what you're trying to do. Maybe then you may even recall me taking a class. Okay, you may even remember that you were sitting in that. All those factors will be important for you to, recall the material, what you have to write in your exam. And now here what you're doing is you're recalling from your memory also. Okay, this is what you're doing is operation. So content was your question, which was in the visual form. Then was your operation, thinking about it, okay? And after that, you write down the answer. And when I read it, ठीक है. नाउ यू मे इन दिस राइटिंग व्हेन यू आर राइटिंग यू मे बी यूजिंग लॉट मेनी यू नो एसोसिएशंस विच आर द प्रोडक्ट्स. ओके, वंस योर आंसर इज रिटन यू हैव गिवन मी ए काइंड ऑफ प्रोडक्ट. ठीक है. Guilford's, I think 10:30 only. Na Guilford tomorrow is. We will complete Guilford tomorrow. Okay. It's a very nice, slightly difficult theory. But if you have grasped, then you never forget. So we have content. Content is from where you get the stimuli. Either you get it through visual stimuli, or you get it through auditory stimuli, or you might see the symbols. In certain languages also there are a lot many symbols, plus sign, minus sign, like you know what to do. Okay, then you may be given the meaning, semantic. Okay, where you must be handling the language part, where you try to understand the meanings. Even in your, when you we are saying the question which you are going to read, you are trying to understand the meaning of those words, what I want from you. Okay, or maybe your behavioral actions, the stimuli. Like for example, if you see somebody crying or you see somebody laughing, okay, if somebody is crying, you may go that near that child, ki bhai what happened to you. Okay, and you presume because the child is crying, maybe something is wrong. Okay, whereas if somebody is laughing, you may not be, you know, you may get attentive towards it, but you may not feel that there is any kind of emergency. Okay, now in this operations, what operations you will be right? Either you will be evaluating the situation, as I told you, when the person is crying, you're trying to evaluate why the person is crying. Okay. Jahan you are trying to do divergent thinking. Divergent thinking is where you are, you know, you using your own creativity, which is different from individual to individual. Or your convergent thinking. Convergent thinking is the one where the divergent thinking where you have a problem, but you have multiple solutions. Okay. And convergent thinking mein there is only one solution and you come to that solution where they say 2 plus 2 is 4. 2 plus 2 cannot be anything else. When we are mathematical ability mein jab humare questions galat hote hain ya theek hote hain, here what we are doing is using our convergent thinking. Okay, because answer is one only. If you are not able to arrive to that answer, that means your convergent ability, you are slightly poor. Then our memory, okay, we are trying to recall from our experiences. ठीक है, मान लो कि ऐसा हुआ था, अरे यार हाँ ऐसा हुआ था, then I did this, let me try to do that. Okay, and then our other cognitions. Now products में आ जाएगा either one unit or class of relationships or systems transformations. We will do it in the next class because time is going to get over. Okay, we will be needing around 2 more classes for this our intelligence, then we'll move to the other. Abhi to tumhari classes to chal rahi hai na, you don't have any holidays.
क्लासेस अभी चल रही है मैम.
ठीक है बेटी. ओके, सो आई विल स्टॉप द क्लास हियर नाउ.
थैंक यू मैम.
इज इट क्लियर?
यस मैम.
ओके बेटी.